For years, the Horn of African nation of Djibouti was seen by foreign powers as little more than a far-flung military outpost overseeing the Gulf of Aden. But now, Djibouti is trying to capitalize on its key position along one of the busiest shipping lanes in the world, the gateway to the Suez Canal, an African base overlooking Arabia.
It was always said that Djibouti was the land of encounters and exchanges. I think this is true, and now we're trying to prove that it's currently going the way of Dubai and even Singapore.
Djibouti already operates as the main port for landlocked Ethiopia, and they're strengthening that connection further. A short drive outside the city, Chinese workers are busy building a new railway line linking Ethiopia's capital of Addis Ababa with Djibouti, reviving a line that has been defunct for decades. The 450-mile line is being built at a cost of $4 billion by China Railway Engineering Construction. By both land and sea, Djibouti wants to position itself as the gateway for Asia into Africa.
Of 17 landlocked countries on the continent, 10 are in the Kumisa region with 400 million inhabitants. So these countries need maritime and port infrastructure to trade with the rest of the world.
For now, Djibouti mainly serves Ethiopia's 90 million consumers, but their ambition extends to the entire continent. As well as its port and railway projects, Djibouti wants to add 2 new airports and build industrial areas. A total of 14 infrastructure projects are planned here, totaling some $14.4 billion, mainly financed by Chinese banks. But some are wary of such huge investments for a country with less than 1 million people. Djibouti faces widespread poverty, with over 43% unemployment.
Now with the Chinese, we take all possible loans for all projects. It is they who manage, and we've lost control.
But Djibouti's government is betting on strong African economic growth to recoup the investment and set itself on a path to becoming the Dubai of the Horn.